हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस वन स्टैंडर्ड। एज वी वर वर्किंग विद लेसन नंबर 7, 5 ईयर प्लान्स इन इंडिया। प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फर्स्ट टिल 8 5 ईयर प्लान्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर प्लान्स, दैट इज 5 ईयर प्लान 9, 5 ईयर प्लान नंबर 10, 11 एंड 12। इकोनॉमिक प्लानिंग इन इंडिया, 5 ईयर प्लान्स एंड डेवलपमेंट स्ट्रेटेजीज। एज यू नो दैट ऑन द ईव ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस द कंडीशन ऑफ इंडियन इकोनॉमी वॉज स्टेग्नेंट एंड बैकवर्ड। एज नियर अबाउट 85% ऑफ द इंडियन पॉपुलेशन वॉज डिपेंडेंट ऑन एग्रीकल्चर ड्यू टू द डिकेइंग ऑफ द हैंडीक्राफ्ट इंडस्ट्रीज। ब्रिटिशर्स has focused on the cash crops, not on the food crops. That's why agriculture sector was also not so developed in the colonial rule. So there are many difficulties in front of Indians that how to cover all these problems. This impoverished condition of the economy had to be settled. For this, every strategy for an effective economic planning had to begin from scratch. The leaders of independent India had to decide upon such an economic system which was the best suited to the country. That's why they have adopted the path of mixed economy, in which there is a coexistence of private and public sector was there. The target during the 5 year plan was to increase the economic growth with the increase in the GDP, that is the gross domestic product or the national income of the country, and the per capita income without any inflationary rise in the prices of the output, and make the improvements in agriculture, service sector and industrial sector to improve the standard of living by giving education, health facilities, etc. Key terms related to the topic, first one is inflation, GDP, services. Inflation means when the circulation of money supply in the economy, it is more than the production of goods and services in a financial year. With this, what happened, the prices of the commodities and the services will rise and the value of money will be decreased. So inflation is a process of continuous increase in the price level. Inflation results in a decrease in the value of money. In the definition of inflation, we have to observe that inflation is an increase in the prices of all goods and services, not only of a particular good or service. An increase in the price of one good is not inflation. Inflation is an ongoing process, not a one-time jump in the price level. Gross domestic product means the national income of a country. When the output of all the goods and services in a particular financial year, suppose 2019, when we will measure the value of all these goods and services in terms of money, that is known as a national income. Suppose the GDP of a country for the financial year, that is 2019, was 10,000 units of production. And when we have measured the value of all these goods and services in terms of money, that was rupees 1 lakh. So that 1 lakh is the gross domestic product or the national income of the country. So GDP or gross domestic product is the market value of all the final goods and services. Final goods and services like dresses, cars, Activas, motorcycle, cycles, books, pencils, and services like doctors, engineers, cobblers, chartered accountants and number of other persons are there, other services are there, which are produced in a country in a given time period. This definition has four parts. First one is market value of all the goods and services. Which goods and services? Final goods and services that is produced within a country in a given period of time, that is 2019, that is known as our GDP. Services, a type of economic activity, that is a work done in order to earn the money, that is intangible, and those services we can't touch, intangible means, is not stored, because services we can't store, and does not result in ownership. A service is consumed at the point of sale. Services are one of the two key components of economics. The other one is goods. Examples of services include the transfer of goods, such as the postal services, postal service delivering mail, and use of expertise or experience, such a person visiting a doctor. Objectives of 9th 5-year plan. The total outlay of the 9th 5-year plan was for the public sector allocated was ₹8,59,000 crore, but the actual expenditure was ₹8,59,000 crore. So it means that 100% achievement was there in the 9th 5-year plan according to the total outlay. The objectives of the 9th 5-year plan was creation of employment opportunity by setting up of a new industries and increase the employment opportunities in the tertiary sector, like in the field of banking, that one insurance, transportation, shipping, all these. Now next one is control the population growth with the family planning programs, removal of the illiteracy by giving education in the government schools, provide safe drinking water, growth of agriculture sector by giving HYV seeds to the farmers at the subsidized rates, and train the farmers according to the new technology in the agriculture sector. Expansion in the transport. Expansion in the transport means shipping and buses, railways, aeroplanes. In this way, these were the objectives of 9th 5-year plan. In the 9th 5-year plan, a time period from 1997 till 2002, 9th 5-year plan of India runs had the main aim of attaining objectives like speedy industrialization, human development in the sense that giving knowledge and improve the standard of living, health facilities, full scale employment means given jobs to the to all the persons, poverty reduction programs, and self-reliance on domestic resources means there is cut off the import and dependence on the foreign aid. 9th 5-year plan was formulated amidst the backdrop of India's golden jubilee of independence. The main objective of 9th 5-year plan in India were to prioritize agriculture sector and emphasize on the rural development. Rural development in the sense that making roads, flyovers, bridges, irrigation facilities provision. Next one is to generate adequate employment opportunities and promote the poverty reduction. To stabilize the prices in order to accelerate the growth rate of the economy. Stabilize the prices means that there is no inflationary rise in the prices of the commodities, so that stability can be maintained in the economy with the proper supply of the circulation of money to ensure food and nutritional security. Achievements of the 9th 5-year plan. rate of growth of GDP, that is gross domestic product, fallen down to 5.3% because of the decline in the rate of growth of agriculture and manufacturing, the rate of agriculture being 2.06% and that of manufacturing 3.68%. So due to the industrial lesser production, industrial sector, and output also lesser in the agriculture sector, it adversely affect the national income of the country. In the 9th 5-year plan, the public sector performance was below expectations because of the financial crisis. No financial support was there for the public sector projects. The performance of India's external sector was satisfactory. Current account deficit in India's balance of payment came down, and current account surplus of 0.7% of the national income, that is GDP, was generated. Failures of the 9th 5-year plan. Growth rate of agriculture was only 2.1%. Manufacturing growth rate was also less. Means output in the industrial sector was not up to the mark. Domestic savings and investments was also not realized. Plan was failed to check the unemployment rate. 10th 5-year plan, time period 2002 till 2007. In the 10th 5-year plan, aimed at an average annual GDP growth rate of 8% with major focus on human development and family welfare programs. Objectives of 10th 5-year plan was priority to the agricultural and rural development programs, increase the growth rate of the economy, means increase the GDP by increasing the agricultural output like wheat, rice, so that we can export these commodities to the other countries in order to get more receipts. Next one is rural development, like making of roads, irrigation facilities, and giving lands to the poor farmers so that they can earn their livelihoods by growing crops, provide the food and nutritional security, improve the environment by plantation, containing the growth rate of population, strengthening efforts to achieve self-reliance, promote and developing people's participatory institutions like Panchayati Raj institutions, cooperatives, etc. Providing basic services like safe drinking water, that is a primary health care also, facilities provision to the people. Increase the national income of the country with the increase in the output in agriculture sector and industrial sector, and increase in per capita income. Achievements of the 10th 5-year plan. Growth rate, the economic survey 2006 till 7 shows that growth rate of GDP at 1999 till 2000, prices was only 3.5% in 2002 till 2003, but then jumped to 8.8% and 7.3% in 2003 till 4 and 2004 till 5. In 2006 till 07, growth rate was recorded at 9.2%. Next one is, this growth rate was the result of increase in the national income of a country, and this national income of a country will be increased due to the appreciation of export of the agricultural commodities and use of machinery domestically made in the industrial sector, and use of labor intensive technology in the industries in order to generate the employment. All these things were helpful in the improvement of the standard of living due to the jobs with the people. Employment generation, the results of the 61st NSSO National Sample Survey Organization round shows that above 47 million persons were provided employment during 2000 till 2005. In the agriculture sector, production of agriculture was also increased to 213.2 million tons. Industries was increased at the rate of 8.8% per annum. And in the service sector, services grew at the rate of more than 9% per annum. Price behavior: the average rate of inflation was 3.4% and gradually rose to 6.5% in 2004 till 2005 and then declined to 4.4% in 2005 till 2006. Failures of 10th five-year plan. Growth rate of agriculture was only 2.3%. 10 million jobs were created in the 10th five-year plan, but plan failed due to the adoption of capital-intensive technology in the industrial sector. With this, there is a lesser demand for the labor, manual labor. That's why with the adoption of the new machines, there is generation of unemployment in the economy. Unemployment exists in the economy with the use of the capital intensive technology in the industries. Balanced regional development was also not achieved. The state of Bihar, Odisha, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh not make significant progress. So plan also failed to reduce the gap between rich and poor. Poor becomes more poorer because already they are without jobs and they were earning less. And now due to the adoption of the capital intensive technology in the industries, they are now become unemployed. And the gap between rich and poor, it is vast. 11th five-year plan, that is a period of 2007 till 2012. The title of the 11th plan document was Towards Faster and More Inclusive Growth. This plan began in favorable economic conditions. Objectives of the 11th five-year plan was achieve higher level of per capita income. Per capita income, that is total income of a region divided by the population of the country. Enhancement of human well-being. Human well-being like provision of education, employment and health facilities, ensuring a balanced development for the states. Balanced development like irrigation facilities, roads, dams, flyovers, bridges, subsidies. These are the balanced growth. These should be equal. Then we can say that there is a balanced development for all the states. Reducing the budget deficit. Budget deficit means when the government expenditures are more than the receipts. Expenditure of the government, like while making the roads, dams, bridges, flyovers, given the subsidies to the common public, like liquid petroleum gas cylinders are there. Next one is provision of raw materials to the industries at a cheaper rates. Fair price shops are also there for common public. So these are the government expenditure. When the government expenditures are more than the government receipts, then there is a budget deficit. And the budget expenditure always there for the welfare of the economy. Critical evaluation for this plan. National income, that is GDP, decreased from 8% to 7.8%. Industrial growth rate goes down. Gross domestic savings goes down. India's 12th five-year plan, a period from 2012 till 2017. Objectives of the 12th five-year plan was achieve the faster growth rate of national output. To make the growth rate more inclusive in nature, means there's an increase in national income, increase in the production of goods and services. Goods like production of AC, production of cars, production of fans, production of any kind of vehicles, and the production of dresses, production of shoes, production of jewelry. All these are the sources with which we can increase the rate of growth of an economy, to increase the self-dependency. Self-dependency means that when there is lesser support from the foreign, that is lesser foreign aid, and the foreign borrowings at a concessional rates. So to control the population growth with the adoption of the family planning programs. So these were the objectives of the 12th five-year plan. There is an increase in the communication facilities also in the 12th five-year plan. Evaluation of planning in India. India has completed decade of planning. By comparing the performance of last 40 years with economic progress, record of achievements can be observed. Though the rate of growth of population increased, the per capita income doubled. Means earnings with the people are less and family members are more. So food grains increased, industrial production increased about 10 folds during this period. Achievements of planning. Growth in national product. National product means like AC, car, shoes, dresses, all these are the national products. Growth in domestic savings by the household. And the capital formation means infrastructure, it is there. New colonies, hospitals, schools, that is the capital formation. Growth in agricultural and industrial production. Agricultural production like growth in the food grains, wheat, rice, pulses, cotton, sugarcane, fruits, and industrial production like cars, trucks, buses, any other vehicles, textile industries, sugar industries. So there is a growth in the agriculture and industrial production. This was an achievement in the 12th five-year plan. Improvement in economic infrastructure. Remarkable progress towards the economic self-reliance. Lesser aid from the foreign countries. Diversification of exportable and production of import substitutions. Import substitution means like suppose we have to import sugar from other countries. So in order to lessen the import of the sugar, we will use homemade jaggeries. So jaggery, it is make in India. Modernization, adoption of the new technology. Progress in the health and educational facilities. More government schools and hospitals were set up in the country. Basic failures of Indian planning. Failures of eradicate poverty. Reason is this one, that lesser funds with the governments. There are many programs started for the eradication of the poverty, like 100 days Rozgar Yojana, Manrega, it is there, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Guarantee Act schemes are there, and still it is working. But due to proper financial funds, due to the lack of proper financial funds, we are failure to eradicate the poverty, failures to solve the unemployment problems. Still, maximum youth it is unemployed. Next one is, government is a failure to generate the employment opportunities for the youth. Lesser setup of the industries. Industrial sector, it is not firmly set up. Failure in the reducing income and wealth inequalities. Fall in the growth rate of agricultural production like wheat, rice, cotton, sugarcane. Failure to generate sustained growth rate in the industrial production like iron and steel factories. aluminium, iron ores. So failures to solve the unfavorable balance of payment account. Unfavorable balance of payment account means when payments are more, means import it is more and export it is less. Payments are more and receipts are less. In these planning periods, failure in proper implementation of plan programs because of financial crisis. Financial support was not there, due to which Indian plannings are failures. Students, hope you have understood the topic of 5-year plans. Now it's time to note down the homework. Define the following terms with examples: inflation, GDP, service sector. And second question is, make a chart showing the objectives of 9th 5-year plan, 10th 5-year plan, 11th 5-year plan and 12th 5-year plan. And students, please go through the links also for more clarity. Students, hope you all will note down the homework in your copy for better learning. Thank you for listening, students.